We do need to involve men in decisions about gender equality. If we do not have a gender equality in any home, in any community, the community at large is seriously at risk, because there are very substantial economic costs in the occurrence of violence against women. The productivity of the home is already seriously undermined. The productivity and cohesion of the community is also undermined. And in the end, a country needs to pay for all that.
I think menopause is so important because men, they are the cause of all the problems and social issues that we have. In our societies, it's the men that causes a lot of, you know, problems. We have to educate men in order to change the society. For instance, you talk about women, like women talk about issues that affect them. It doesn't really, you know, help men to understand that. But we have to have men to talk about issues that affect, you know, women and our community, so that, you know, men might change their mindset to understand what issues we are facing and what we are talking about. I think it's very important. And the other thing is, like, we have women fighting for their rights, you say, domestic violence and all that. I think you see on the source, like, when we go for protests and all that, it's all the women that are going and not the men. But I think what we are doing is very important to change the mindset of the people. For men to go behind issues that affect our community and especially women and older people, men to understand what we are doing. It's very important.
So we want to have conversations and discussions. It's about provoking ideas, provoking discussion, provoking different thinking, different line of thinking. It's not about doing projects. We don't want to really go down and do projects. We want to sit down and talk about it. And so hopefully we will start generating these ideas in the community, and we hope that we can cause a ripple effect, that those communities that are changing attitudes and behaviors toward each other and are coming up with good, solid families will begin to become successful. And then other people will, other communities will probably say, oh, so you guys have been successful. You guys are doing something good, so what are you doing differently?
We really need a broader supportive social environment that really looks at, you know, how we can better support women and their empowerment in the communities. And we really need to start challenging the status quo and certain elements in the community that excuse the use of violence. We need to start looking at our curriculum, at our educational system, both formal and informal. What are we teaching our young men? What are we teaching our young boys? What are we teaching our girls and our young women in these schools and in these educational institutions? And we really need to start challenging certain myths around culture and tradition and also religion, about certain aspects of women and women's role and also men's role in the community that then prohibits the development of a community.